Hello, my name is Vinita Chetri and I'm currently working in Pradhan as an executive, and we are in Murakati village of Nayagram block in Jhargram, and we are working with women like these, like Taposhi and Gauri and Bhanupriya, and we are currently engaged in cultivation of indigenous varieties of rice in 6 of the panchayats in this block, and we have a coverage of 500 hectares which 5,000 farmers are engaged in, and this year we are cultivating 8 varieties of indigenous varieties rice. They are Adan Shilpa, Malia Fulo, Kerala Sundari, JP 110, JP 57, Bacha Bhog, Shathia, and all of these varieties are being cultivated organically without any use of chemical or chemical pesticides or fertilizers. The spraying machine that you see towards my right, this machine is not going to be used for spraying any kind of pesticide or poison on these crops, but it will be used to control pest population by means of organic pest control, like garlic, kerosene and cow urine.
So what do you think, that the women farmers are accepting these varieties well or not?
The varieties and the whole endeavor has been quite successful. It has been going on since last year. We started with 2-3 varieties last year, and this year we've expanded the scope of those varieties. It was quite successful, and women have been very accepting of the endeavor because they recognize the need to move away from an input intensive and expensive and unsafe production of food. So in this remote corner of West Bengal, in Jhargram, the endeavor has been successful and widely accepted by the communities here.
So how do you got the seeds?
We source the seeds from different conservationists in different parts of the state. Some of the seeds we've procured from government farms, like farms in Nodia. Some we have gotten from conservationists in different parts of the state, like Kuch Bihar, some from East Midnapur, some from Bardhaman.
So do you feel any difficulty in selling these varieties, the seeds and the rice that you produce here?
For the first year, the intention was to produce safe food for the farmers itself. So marketing wasn't really a concern, but now that the production has increased and thousands of farmers are producing these, so there has to be a way in which these have to be marketed. So marketing is one thing that has been a focus this year, and the women have set up a producers company this year, and so this producers company is looking at both large-scale paddy export as well as small-scale rice production in a mill that has been set up by the company.
That means your companies?
No, it's not my company. The company is called Amon, Amon Women's Farmers Organization. So it is completely owned by the women.
Great.
Who grow
Great.
These varieties, and
this is
unique. Fully owned by these women.
So what do you expect from others? What do you expect from other farmers or other parts of West Bengal?
I expect that the
What's your message?
I would say that for this movement to really grow and really be successful, everybody needs to join hands. And as of now, the goal for our particular block is to make the entire block poison-free. And we would want and encourage other people in other parts of the country and the state to join us in this movement to make all of Bengal poison-free.
Thank you.